back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing and hitting that notification button. If you have any thoughts, questions or suggestions as we go along, then please feel free to comment those down below. Let's look at the masterpiece Kanthapura, which was written by Raja Rao. Kanthapura is set during Indian independence movement. It was a novel published in 1938. Let us look at the characters of Kanthapura. The first is Achakka. Achakka is the story narrator, is a woman from the village of Kanthapura. Second is Murthy, the book's central protagonist, and he is a young Brahmin who rejects the hierarchical caste system. Murthy is the major character of novel, is a Brahmin, a graduate and a clean child. Let's look at the next character, Rangamma. Rangamma, she is a widow in Kanthapura who becomes the Gandhian movement's secondary leader. Next character is Ratna. She is a young woman whose husband died soon after she married at the age of 10. The villager treats her below caste pariha and source of shame. Let us look at the critical reception by one of the great European writer named E.M. Forster. Remarked, Kanthapura is the finest novel to come out of India in recent years. This was a critical reception given by E.M. Forster. Raja Rao in preface says, we cannot write like the English, we should not. He demonstrates in this line how the English language can be used to tell a typically Indian story without violating the native speech rhythms. Two important geographical landmarks that features throughout the novel of Kanthapura is firstly Kenchamma. This is Kenchamma Hill. Kenchamma Hill, which is of red color. The reason of Kenchamma Hill being red colored is because goddess Kenchamma killed a demon ages ago. A demon that had come to ask young sons as food and young women as wife. Goddess Kenchamma battled many knights to slay a demon and blood from the battle soaked the hill. Second geographical landmark of Kanthapura is River Himavati. The river is holy to the villages. Achakka explains that Himavati is daughter of Kenchamma. Now let's look at the plot. Achakka is delightful old woman who commands with wisdom and humor. Achakka introduces strict caste or jati system in Kanthapura that divides people into separate communities. At the topmost are Brahmins who are priests and teachers. On the second are the weavers and potters. At the bottom are Shudras and Parihas, who mostly perform manual labor. They are also known as untouchables. Now, in the opening chapter, we find there is a famous Harikatha man named Jayaramachar. Murthy pays to Jayaramachar to come to Kanthapura in the first chapter. Now, Harikatha means story of Lord. Jayaramachar, the Harikatha man, mixes politics with religion where he says Shiva is three-eyed and Swaraj is three-eyed. Self-purification, Hindu-Muslim unity and Khada. Now, Swaraj means Swa means self and Raj means rule, where he says Gandhi ji will come to liberate the people of India. So this is how Jayaramachar, the Harikatha man, mixes politics with religion. In the next scene, we find that Murthy has a vision. in which he fans Mahatma Gandhiji and hears the words by him, "There is but one force in life and that is truth, and there is but one love in life and that is the love of mankind, and there is but one God in life and that is the God of all." After this, Murthy becomes stormy and idealistic, and his fight against conservative forces start. Murthy declares himself Gandhi's slave, and thereby he influences other people to do so.
The people of Kanthapura, who are followers of Mahatma Gandhi, proclaims their loyalty to independence movement. A protest breaks out where people start saying, "Vande Mataram, Inqilab Zindabad, Mahatma Gandhi ki jai," where they are saying victory to Mahatma Gandhi. After the aggressive Protestant movement, we find that in the middle of the night, the two main leaders, Murthy and Rangamma, are arrested. And one officer nearly rapes Ratna, the widow girl. We find that one of the protesters raises the Gandhian revolutionary flag, and the police begin firing against the protesters. The woman hides out and decides to flee from Kanthapura.
Rachi then says, quote, "In the name of goddess, I burn this village." Then the woman decides to burn Kanthapura, their village, into fire, and the entire village is set into fire. This is such a tragedy. This is how tragically the novel ends.